H2K Infosys provides world-class online IT training, staffing, and software testing solutions to customers worldwide. H2K Infosys supports 100% job-oriented training, hands-on project work, cloud test lab, resume preparation and review, mock interviews, robust syllabus. One-time pay, lifetime access to live classes and videos. H2K Infosys has won the trust of thousands of students worldwide. For free demo class, visit h2kinfosys.com.
Welcome to the videos of H2K Infosys. So in the last video, we saw the practicalities on the integer data type and the long data type. In this particular video, we're going to see the practicalities on the float and double. So we're going to handle and check out how does a variable react if it is declared as a float or a double data type. So let's go and move towards the practicalities of it. So I'll open up my Eclipse right now. And in Eclipse, I'll create a new project. I'll call this project as session 3. And I'm going to click on next and click on the finish. Not going to change the perspective of it. And in this particular project, I'm going to create a package called as data types. Click on finish button, and inside the package I'm going to create a class file called as float underscore double underscore data types. I'll call in the main method because I want to throw the result in the console of Eclipse IDE. So double click on this particular tab. It opens up the coding plane to the maximum level, and here we're going to see the practicalities on the float and double data type. So first let us take up the float data type. Now the keyword used for float data type is float small f, and I declare a variable a as, let's say, 20. Now let us remember the one particular thing as a note out here, that a variable declared as a float data type, put this within the single line of comment, and that is why I'm using double forward slash. So a variable declared as a float data type should have the declared value in non-decimal format. Result of this variable thrown in the console will be in decimal format. Okay, so let us remember this particular note. So I have declared a variable a as a float data type, and I have declared the value of it in non-decimal format. That is how we need to declare the value of a variable a, which is a float data type. Now if I want to get the result in the console, I have to use the println command sysout, then use the control and spacebar keys, and I can write down the value of variable a is concatenating the string format with the variable a, which is nothing but your float format. So when we are actually want to get the result in the console will throw out this part as it is, because you have put it in the string format, that is within double quotes, and you are concatenating the string format with the float format, because the variable a is declared as a float data type. So when you are actually amalgamating or adding up a string format with any other format, you got to use the concatenation operator that is defined by the plus sign. Okay, or rather I would say that if you are trying to concatenate any other data type with any other data type, the concatenation operator has to be used, that is the plus sign. But yes, there are other rules for concatenation, so we'll see that later on. Okay, so if I right now save the class file and run it, I'll get the value of A as 20.0. So it is storing the result in the console in decimal format. Now let's say I have one more variable called float B, and I declare the value of it in decimal format, let's say 30.0. If you see out here, there is a syntax error coming, and that is why there's a red underline. And if I hover my mouse over the cross red button, it says type mismatch, cannot convert from double to float. That means this part is a double format. The decimal format is actually considered as a double format. So how can you define a variable B as float, whereas the value declaration is in double format? That's not possible, and that is why the compiler shows you a problem. Okay, so here what is happening is that the value declared is in double format, whereas the variable has been defined with float data type. And because of this mismatch of the formats, we are getting this particular syntax error. Okay, so I'm going to comment this. Okay, now let's say I have another variable called float C, and the value of this is equal to, let's say, 40. Now when I add up the value of variable A with value of variable C and put it to a variable, let's say D. So I define a variable D. So this variable will hold the added value of the variable A and C, so which is equal to A plus C. Now the compiler is not going to show us any kind of problem, because the declared value is in non-decimal format. Non-decimal format, I can also call it as a double, what you call as an integer format. Okay, for the purpose of understanding. So this is rather nothing but the declaration of the this particular variable is in non-decimal format. And as I have told you, float variables can have value declaration in non-decimal format, and that is why it is getting accepted. Now if I basically use a sysout, it is a println command, and I type in the value of the variable D is, concatenate the string format with the variable D which is in float format, that is why you are using the plus sign for concatenation purpose. You save this particular class file and you run it, you get the value of D as 40 plus 20, which is equal to your 60 out here. Now if you see the value thrown out in the console, the result will be thrown out in double format or decimal format, whatever you can call it as. Okay.